they are not understanding gurus and brahmins are the roots of Hinduism. If you eliminate these two, Hinduism will be gone. They think the neo-Hindutva people, the neo-Hindus, they really believe they can keep Hinduism alive by eliminating gurus and brahmins. Fools don't understand. Gurus and brahmins kept the Hinduism alive. Archavatara and Nijavataras kept Hinduism alive. Brahmins worshipping, keeping the Archavatara tradition. Gurus keeping the Nijavatara tradition. Kept Hinduism alive. Unique two principles of Hinduism is God descends in the form of deity in a specific place. Hindu temples are living place of living abodes of gods and goddesses, not just worship altars, theology training centers, education organizations alone, or it is not just prayer altars alone. It is living abode of gods and goddesses. That is why once a Hindu temple, the prana pratishta is done, consecration is done, you can't move it, you can't sell it. The Hindu temple land loses real estate value. It doesn't belong to any more planet Earth. Our planet sets real estate market. There is no real estate value for Hindu temple. The second important principle of Hinduism is Daivam Manushya Rupena. God lands in human body and manifests himself using human being and human identity. The Neo-Hindutva people, Neo-Hindus, does not believe in both principles, neither in Archavatara nor in Nijavatara. That is where the whole problem starts. They are brainwashed so much by the media cult and entertainment cult, even the Neo-Hindus don't believe. They are as much as anti-Guru and anti-Brahmins, as the anti-Hindu elements. Deadly combination of missionary militants and militant missionaries and Neo-Hindus ganged up is literally eliminating Hinduism from India. It's unfortunate, but the reality. I want international Hindu diaspora to wake up to this reality. Hindu diaspora need to wake up to this reality. The Hindu diaspora knows Hindus are minority. Still in India, Hindus are brainwashed that they are majority. Fools. Now the whole world is a global country. There's no such thing as individual country, especially after the advent of the internet and social media. We are all living in the internet, the world's largest city. Is internet. At any given time, 2 billion people are living there. We are all citizens of internet. We should call ourselves as netizens. In net, Hindus are minority. Wake up to that truth. Internationally, Hindus are minority. And in India, media allows in the field of media, FDA is allowed. The deadly nexus of NGOs and media literally makes Hindus minority. Understand? Foreign direct investments and NGOs. Through that, the international majority religions pump in money, and even though Hindus are majority in India, they are not that organized. Indian Hindus, if you think you are a majority, you are a fool. You are deluded. Internationally, you are minority. Inside India also, you are minority. Anyone who has studied the whole international ecosystems will wake up to this truth. NRIs, the Hindu diaspora, settled all over the world, knows Hindus are minority. So you can wake up to whatever I am saying easily. Please wake up.